Hallo, Michael Klemme hier. I'm the Senior Solutions Architect at Arcolinks. I do all kinds of customer-related work like pre-sales, consultancy, integrations, etc. I've been around in the technical information arena for 20 years, working in companies doing aerospace documentation, engineering documentation, software, etc. And I will show you Arcolinks and how it integrates into the Arbortext product today. Yes, what I'm going to show is basically giving a short overview of Arcolinks as a platform, what Arcolinks will help you do. We'll then show you the configuration of Arcolinks shortly and then show you how the Arcolinks integration works in Arbortext. So Arcolinks is a content governance platform. It allows you to define your standards, and then all the writing force in your organization can write content that is aligned with these standards that you've been defining before. And we do that with an artificial intelligence engine that we've been developing over the last 17 plus years. So we've been in the market for a long time, and well, we proudly call ourselves an AI company. So Arcolinks is, as said, a joint system that everybody can use in the organization. And when you use Arcolinks, for instance, workflows can be streamlined. Authors can fix their issues directly in while writing the content in the editor. There's a reduction in ping pong between authoring and review, etc. That helps you to increase the operations efficiency of your content production. And it also allows you to create more content with the same budget, since you are going to saving time and money on reviews and rewrites. Arcolinks allows you to set standards, and this includes the important and proper words for things. It also includes standards like to write readable, and that helps you to eliminate the risk and be compliant with certain standards. One standard in the industry is the ASDST 100 Aerospace Technical English Standard, for instance, but there are also other regulation, for instance, in the machine industry, in medical devices, where you are required to deliver content that is readable, and therefore having Arcolinks eliminates risk of some issues around that corner. And even if you have Arcolinks, you will not only for one target audience, you'll have multiple target audiences, and therefore writing for different audiences can also be supported by supplying different configurations for those audiences. So we've, as said, we've been doing that for quite a while now. We are selling Arcolinks globally. Arcolinks is a German company from Berlin. We basically have most of the major large software companies as our customers. They normally use, or many of them use Arcolinks for their documentation, but many of them also use Arcolinks to check all the UI content, the UI strings, etc., that they have. We have many customers in the healthcare industry. Their readability and compliance is a very hot topic. You need to be delivering content that everybody understands. And some of the customers also are heavily concerned about terminology. They have terminology workflows and terminology checking processes in place. The aerospace industry is also very security cautious. As mentioned before, there is an aerospace standard, ASDST 100, that some of these customers follow and need to follow due to contractual obligations. But Arcolinks also is used in heavy machinery, in truck manufacturers, manufacturers of construction machinery or farming equipment. And they also do that for quality. But some of the very long-term customers here in this column basically discovered that Arcolinks helps them save translation cost. If you align your content and have more similarity in your content, then translation cost goes down. And that's also true for the other parts here. Engineering, like all kinds of machinery industries, etc. We have high-tech companies that do electronics and lot of people in the financial sector. And they all have in common that they create complex products, and those complex products need to be documented and shipped to the end customer with documentation and information that is clearly readable. Okay, so how do we do that? As mentioned before, it's a threefold step. We first set the standards. We capture the standard of your organization. And we do that basically by looking at your style guides. We can mask process content and extract how people have been writing, and that may well be contradictory to the style guide that you have in place. You can then use our colleagues to align your content. So inside the editing systems we are integrated, your writer can directly deliver content that is aligned with the standards defined. And we then have a component that allows you to analyze all the content that has been processed with Arcolinks, and you can then have an overview if you have been reaching the target of compliance, basically. Okay. And we think we are quite well equipped for many of those use cases that I described before. After all, technical product information has a lot of similarity across all those companies that we saw on the list before. We have a very large suitcase of guidances, basically, that we have guidelines that we can deploy at the different customers. So if you have a requirement, I'm pretty much sure that we've seen something similar already. Melissa, I think that some of the audience can speak. Can you mute the general audience?
Sure, let me try muting them again. My apologies.
Okay, fine. Okay, so we support very large enterprises. We have customers with thousands of Arcolinks users. We have customers with 5 Arcolinks users. So we support large and small organizations. We have a very long list of integrations into different tools like Arbitex, etc., like Word, Office. Therefore, we think that we can be of help to the entire organization, because if you look at it, then many office workers create content that will at one stage reach your customer and therefore be of importance to be somehow quality controlled. How does that relate to Arbitex as a tool? So Arbitex is an editing system, editing and publishing system. So we are basically in the align column. So Arcolinks is integrated directly into Arbitex editor. So we'll see that in a moment. Writers can check their content while writing. So they can be sure that they do a good job. If you are from the aerospace industry, then you may have a contractual requirement to write according to ASTE 100. ASTE 100, Simplified Technical English, is a standard that was invented for aerospace maintenance manuals. It is very strict and has a high overhead. So we do not recommend it outside aerospace. But if you have a requirement like an aerospace manufacturer or defense manufacturer, then we are also there to support your needs. But even in aerospace companies, something like operations manuals, for instance, will not be ASTE 100 controlled. So you can then equip your operations manuals team with a different rule set and still check for ASTE 100 compliance in your maintenance manuals. And what I always find quite important is that the documentation team is not alone creating product content. Very often you rely on specifications, on maintenance descriptions created by engineers upstream before you do your documentation work. And wouldn't it be nice if those documents would also be halfway according to your standards? Don't molest an engineer with sentence length and avoiding passive tense, for instance, but they could at least adhere to terminology, spelling, grammar, or component names, etc. So even if you slim down the breadth of Arcolinks for other teams, it would still improve the entire content flow, because if you in engineering have issues, understanding what's produced upstream, then you have a hard time getting this written down in a meaningful way. All right, so let's have a look how we do that. So firstly, I said we would look at standards. And standards basically, if it comes to Arcolinks, breaks down into three things. It's the important words, that's generally called terminology. And then there are linguistic settings. If you look at the terminology first, Arcolinks has a built-in terminology database. It follows the usual status of terms. A term is proposed and then qualified to be preferred or not to be used, deprecated. And we can do that across all languages. So even for languages that you do not check with Arcolinks, we can maintain the terminology. You can then use that in the translation process later. And if you look at the details, you can have a fully-fledged terminology data model. You can have a definition, for instance. You can have images. You can have terminology in different languages, like here in German and English. And here, for instance, we say that in this company that we call MyDemo, we do not talk about clients and consumers. We talk about customers. Clients and consumers is deprecated, not to be used. Customers is the preferred word to use. So while writing, if somebody writes about the consumer, that person will be alerted to write customer instead. Terminology can be a lot of work. So if there are other people in the organization that have terminology already set up, like the translation people, like product marketing for product names, etc., it would always be good to source terminology from them and just load the list of all the products into the system so you don't have to redo that and do that again. Okay, so terminology is one of the three factors for our setup. The next one is guidance. So for the different languages, we can define high-level goals. We have different audiences here. Let's say there is a new target audience, technical documentation. Then we can set for this target audience different parameters. First one is clarity. That is how easy to read the text should be. Clarity is not an absolute measure. You do not want to be ultra simple all the time. If you write to your investors, to analysts, stock market analysts, you probably want to write complex. But for technical documentation, you probably want to write simple. So you select the simple setting here. Next one that we have in the list is conversational tone. Some software companies like Arcolinks want to write their documentation in everyday language today, even using contractions and words that are more colloquial. In a traditional aerospace or machinery company, that's probably not what you want, so you can switch this off. And we have some more things here, like scannability, that is the ease to scan the meaning of a text, so use more titles, use more lists, etc. You can work on acronyms, have your acronyms defined before use. And we have customers that use Arcolinks for job descriptions, for instance. They want to be gender neutral. So you set this for the target audience technical documentation, clarity to simple, scannability on, acronyms on, gender bias off. Beyond those large targets, we also have fine grade rules, and they are here under guidelines. If you look, for instance, at the US marketing guideline set here, and we have different style rules here, grammar and style. And you see we have rules how to set commas, the serial comma, the famous one, comma at introductory phrase, etc. All those kind of things. How to hyphenate certain things, how to write numerals and ordinals, how to write quotes, sentence structure, etc., etc. So you as an organization can set those fine-grained rules here directly in Arcolinks. We will normally help you as part of an introduction project by basically guiding you through this. Many tech talk organizations will be very familiar to those guidelines. We have other organizations from the marketing field probably need some more help. Those rules can also be context specific. Let's see where we have something like this. So the rule period, is there a period missing here? That's about the period at the end of a sentence, like we see in this example. That is a guideline that is switched off for headings, lists, tables, and titles. A title normally does not end in a full stop. So even within a document, you can use arco links to switch on and off certain guidance. And this is done by those kind of what we call a context. In an XML world, that will be an XML element like this tab element in Dita, for instance, for a work step, the title element in many DTDs that we all know around. So those are then mapped to the title elements, and this rule is now turned off for those four contexts that we see here in the list. Okay, so we have now defined the standards. We can then define profiles for certain persons that should use this for their marketing purposes. And then basically we're ready to go, and we can use this system to help authors write better content. You're probably most curious about Arbortext. Those arcolinks integrations, as we call them, are available to very many different authoring systems, the entire Office world, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, all those Google online docs like Microsoft Online, InDesign, FrameMaker, Xmetal, all web applications, etc. So we are quite well equipped, and we hope that we will be able to support most of your authoring teams with an integration. In the case of Arbortext, you see a new Arbortext Arcolinks menu popped up here in Arbortext. There's only one icon. If you click on it, the Arcolinks sidebar opens. And if you connect to the system, you will see all those guidelines that we've been talking about earlier. This is a marketing blog post I'm currently writing, so I better select the marketing guideline set. And when I press the check button, the text is extracted, sent off to the Arcolinks server, and we get those little tiles or cards back that we see here. And they have different colors. Spelling is red, grammar is blue, style, the guidelines, is green, terminology is pink, readability, clarity is brown, conversational tone would be red. And so we see those different tiles here. You can click on a tile, and then we see the word in the document is highlighted. And this expands a bit, so we see some more information. This is a terminology issue. In the domain My Demo, this the word My Demo in a lot of camel case is a variant of My Demo Inc. If I press on more information, I'll be brought directly into the Arcolinks terminology database. The browser will open in a second. Ooh, now I click twice. And we see basically, okay, My Demo Inc. is indeed the term that has been defined. It's preferred for multiple languages. And Demo Inc., the old company name, is the deprecated variant of it. So in this case, we have found a variant of a term. And when we now click here on this green text, the text in question will be replaced by the suggestion. The card will be removed and we jump on to the next. Let's try that. Okay. So we are down to a grammar issue. As it turns out, this is a grammar issue. It should be as it turns out. This is pretty easy, and directly replace it. The next one is an interesting one. This is one of those clarity, readability issues. And what you see here is that Arcolinks highlights the entire sentence. It's a sentence across three lines, pretty long, okay. Arcolinks thinks this is not simple. You remember there was a setting, simple, intermediate, complex, that we could have chosen in our setting. So this is not simple anymore. It's due to those three reasons down here. Firstly, the sentence is long. Okay, we've seen that. Secondly, there is a list inside the sentence. Couldn't you move this out into a bullet point list? And thirdly, there is this ING form, technology supporting this and this and that. This is a very English phenomenon. This does not exist in German. If you want to translate this sentence, the translator will have a big trouble to find a construct to emulate this. So this is a subordinate sentence that's just attached to the end, a very English phenomenon, should probably be avoided. In this case, our colleagues cannot directly give you a replacement, but you can go in and manually rewrite the sentence. We'll do that later. The next one here, serial comma, that is a classical style rule. Do you want to use the comma before the last before the end in the sentence? If you click here on more information, you get into the rule help. That's something we saw earlier already in the configuration. So there is always a little description why this has been decided to be not the choice of the operation. And we also always supply sentences before and after rewrite. So this is like the style guide at your fingertip. The author can go in and basically look up why this has been flagged, and we hope to convince him that this would be a good thing to change. Also something that we can accept automatically. Another terminology issue, it would be a grammar issue also, but it's also covered by terminology, value setting program. Something boils down to that's an overused phrase. You now remember the company was renamed My Demo Inc. from Demo Inc., etc. So I can work here through the document and look at all those things and do all those kind of changes that Akkuring suggests. The author is always in the driving seat. So we only give suggestions. The author can decide what to implement and what not. The author is not overruled by Akkuring. There are no automatic changes. The author is still the person that makes the final decision. Okay, but now how to find out if this is good enough to go? Akkulinks has a little traffic light built in. You see, with the last check we ran, this document is having a score of 70. The color is orange. So there is a traffic light. Red would be well below the agreed standard level. Yellow is below standard level, and green would be above. And the Akkuring score is from 0 to 100. Most organizations would say, okay, aim for something like 80, 85. So you can tell your authors, do not check in content that has an Akkuring score below green, below 80 in this case. So we've accepted a lot of things in this document. You can check again, and hooray, we have hit directly on spot the mark 80. So, according to the agreed corporate standard, this document could now be sent off. But obviously, there is some more small things that I can easily fix. So as a writer, I can probably do some more things before sending this off. And many organizations actually opt to use Akkulinks not only in the authoring tool. They've also integrated Akkulinks into their CMS system so that everything checked into SharePoint, let's say, is automatically Akkuring scored, so that the manager can see in the CMS that this or that document in this collection is below standard. Let's try to rewrite that. So I think that's quite helpful because it gives you the insight across single topics, let's say in the DITA or S1000D world. And you can have insight also for entire publications and collections. This was the work in Arbitext. As said, we have integrations also for Word, for web browsers, etc. So the author can improve their work, basically. And it's like a discrete help to the author. So the author can improve work, and most authors want to do good work. So Akkuring is normally a well-accepted tool because it helps authors to do a good job. Okay, but how to look at this from the corporate level? If we look at the Active Analytics database, that's this subsystem that we have here, we can get an overview over all those checks that have been run in the system. We can segment the writing into different sections, like different types of content, different product lines. That's up to your configuration. And we can see here, for instance, that the learning content department has more than 50% of their document in yellow or red. So we probably need to go and talk to those people. Why can't they deliver content that is of good quality? We see that other people, like the customer teams, for instance, has over 60% in green. The product team has something like over 50%, also room for improvement still. You also see how those lines develop over time. So we see that the compliance team, for instance, has a bit of a dip here somewhere in January. We could go and investigate that. We see who checked how much. For instance, we see that the customer teams only checked a very small fraction of the overall document pool. So we probably need to go and talk to those people and see what is happening. And we also have an overview how our colleagues performs. So if you look at the guidance overview here, for instance, and filter by language, let's give it a second. For instance, look only at English for today. Then we see that some guidelines like could you make it found more formal accounts for, let's say, 20% of all the flags that have been seen in documents. So what's wrong? Either the authors would need a reminder that this is the agreed standard. It may be that the checking process needs to be fine-tuned. Do not apply this rule in certain document types, etc. So it gives you some insight and something to think about how to improve. And if you have been using Arcolinks, let's say, for a year, it gives you a good input into a refinement phase to optimize your content and basically get Arcolinks even better and even more relevant for more and more people in the organization. You also can do a terminology extraction while we are processing here content in Arcolinks. So what we basically see here is that some words were very, very popular. So case study, ebook, algorithm, marketing content were the most popular terms in all those documents that have been checked. So you could directly from here click the little arrow, and then this term will be added to the Arcolinks terminology database as a suggestion. Let's do that for a second. We have been anonymizing the context, as you see, not too clever for this kind of demo. And need to set a domain. Let's put it into the new words for now. And if I, the terminologist, come back next morning, I see that a new proposed term arrived. It's the study, I believe. So we can basically make sure that new words are added continuously from the starter pool to the system. All right, so Arcolinks allows you to set the standards. That's what we did first. It allows your writing force to write according to your standards, and it gives you, as management, tools to check that the standards have been adhered to. That's basically what we showed. If you go back in this slide here, capture, align, analyze. That's basically all I wanted to show today.